Lara, and for those who don't know me, I'm a PhD student here at the university in the Department of Experimental and Applied Psychology. And I have a background in psychology and cognitive neuroscience, and in my PhD project, I focus on the influence of leaders, the neurocognitive influence of leaders on followers. And today I would like to tell you a story about changing perspectives, especially changing perspectives on how we as researchers study the influence of leaders on followers. And to begin, I would like to introduce you to John and William. Both work at the same company. John is the CEO of the company and William is an employee of this company. So let's have a closer look at John. John is a popular leader. He's trusted by his employees and he is able to provide them with a vision that inspires and motivates them to really work as much as possible and as hard as possible to achieve the company's goals. So, as researchers, we are wondering, hey, what makes John such a successful leader? Can we, how is he able to influence his followers, and can we identify mechanisms that underlie this influence? So, in traditional leadership research, you might start by just asking John, hey, what do you think are your leadership qualities? What strategies do you apply to influence and guide your employees? So you would use self-report questions. Another traditionally applied method would be to just observe John's behavior in a case study or conduct a cross-sectional design where you would look at the specific population. So for example, a group of CEOs, a group of team leaders, or a group of people who are in other leadership positions at a specific point in time. However, recently, researchers have started to notice that the role of the employee might be also crucial to the leader-follower interaction process and the influence of leaders or followers. So we think that we should focus more on the role of the follower or the employee. And especially past research points at the importance or the possible importance of how employees and followers such as William process information that they get from their CEO, for example, John. So, for example, researchers have suggested that that followers might downregulate their cognitive capacities when they are exposed to a leader who fulfills certain leadership qualities, for example, a very charismatic leader, or someone they regard as especially credible. And others have proposed that, for example, William might only accept an argument only because this argument is made by John, whom he regards as an outstanding leader. So, first we want to change perspectives, that is shifting the lens from the leader to the follower, but also as a second point, we were thinking about how can we move from more traditional research methods, such as using self-reports or cross-sectional designs or case studies, towards innovative methods which maybe allow us to gain new insights into how leaders influence followers or employees. So can we maybe apply EEG to look into brain activity, which might tell us something how leaders influence followers or employees on a more cognitive or neurocognitive level? Or can we, for example, look into eye tracking and see, hey, is there something William pays especially attention to, or maybe less attention to, when he's, for example, reading a report that John wrote? So yeah, I hope I could give you a little insight into what we're trying to do in my PhD project. That is that, yeah, changing perspectives, first of all, shifting the lens from the leader to the follower, and secondly, looking into how cognitive neuroscience can help us to maybe gain new insights into leader-follower interactions. I'm working on this project together with Mark van Vught, Michiel van Elk, Michael Kandrick, and Jan Theus. And well, if you're a student here at the university and looking for a topic for your master project, well, I have plenty of ideas and maybe you too, so just drop me a mail. Thank you very much for your attention.
One short question.
Any initial outcomes already?
Well, there's some work in progress, but I'm a huge fan of open science, and luckily Mark and my other supervisors as well, so I worked on registered reports, which are currently under review, so I have a lot of proposed study designs, but unfortunately no results yet, so yeah, we have to be a little bit patient.
patient.
Thank you.